Shalom, brothers and sisters. My name is Rabbi Yitzhak Shapira, and I want to talk to you for a moment about my new book, Bsorah According to COVID-19. The book at this point has been released in English, Spanish, Italian. It's been recently released in French. Soon enough, it will be available in German and also in Korean. Why do I think that this is a book for now, for these last days, and why I urge you to go and get the book? It is the prophet Jeremiah the prophet, who explained to us that in the last days there will be a lot, what's called in Hebrew, po'anut. There will be a lot of calamities. And he explained to us that when we see the prophecies of po'anut, they don't have to take place. All the gloom and doom and the chaos that are part of what's called in Hebrew Sarat Yaakov, Jacob trouble, the birth pangs, the coming of the Mashiach, those things do not have to be fulfilled. We have to understand it. If we turn back to God, if we return, if we make teshuvah, if we do the things that God tells us to do, the birthing process can take place. Now, in order for this to take place, we need to know what God has for us, what God wants us to do, both on the individual level and on the corporate level. That's exactly the reason why I wrote the Bsorah According to COVID-19. It said in Tractate Kedushin that each one of us hold the universe in the palm of their hands, each and every one of you. And each decision that you make in those last days, they carry even a greater magnitude for the entire cosmic, to your city, to your country, to the entire world. And that's why we have to be very careful in those last days to understand what are the actions that God has for us, both individually and corporately. And this concept that, hey, I can change the world. I can change the course of the nation, the course of my society, and I can impact the coming of the Messiah. It's something that is not being taught about, is not spoken, but I want you to know something, that each and every one of you have a direct impact about when Messiah will come. It is true, each and every one of you impacting the birthing and the coming of the Mashiach. We are around the corner of 9 to 5, where we're speaking a lot about in rabbinic literature about the coming of the Messiah. According to Jewish tradition, on the 9th of Av, right at midnight, the woman get up, usually the woman, and she start to clean the house. She start to cleanse the house and prepare the house in 9th of Av. And you ask the question, why is it taking place on the 9th of Av? Because the rabbis of Israel say right at midnight, which is represent the mist of the despair and the pain when we're thinking about the destruction of the temple, right there the Geulah is coming in the midst of destruction, which Yeshua said in Matthew chapter 12. He says, out of those dead stones I can raise children. And he says, one that is greater than the temple is standing before you. So the idea that the Mashiach have to appear with the destruction of the temple is very, very Jewish. So the idea of preparing and cleaning the house, getting the house ready for the coming of Mashiach on this time, the time of destruction, the time we see pain and suffering, that's exactly what we have to do. We have to get ready. And that's why I wrote the Bsorah According to COVID-19. I wrote it so you know what is this washing and the cleaning of the house, our spiritual house. And this is one of these shocking principles that is very different in Judaism, let's say, as opposed to Christianity, where Christianity feels that God comes and simply going to come and he's going to take us out of here and bring destruction and judgment. But this is not God's plan. God's plan is to come and tabernacle with us, to dwell inside of us. It says in Exodus chapter 25, I want to come and shachanti betocham. I want to dwell inside of you. Now, in order for him to dwell inside of us, and this tabernacle have a name, it's called the world. In order for him to tabernacle inside of us, he have to have a dwelling place. He have to have a place that he can come and dwell with us. And that's really what this period is all about, is finding the dwelling place and preparing the dwelling place to God. So that's why I invite you to pick up the copy of the book, and don't just read it like a novel. Read it and put yourself into the story and say, God, what do I do? What do I do individually? What do I do with my relationship? What do I do with my connection with others to prepare a place for you to come and to dwell? Because at the end of the day, even Yeshua said, leave your gift at the altar and go reconcile with your brother. Right now, it's a time to call for unity. It's a time for baseless love, baseless hatred. Destroy this first and second temple, and only baseless love will establish the third temple by Messiah, our righteousness. May he come soon. So I encourage you to continue to pray. Look for act of loving kindness. Look to do more mitzvot. Get out of Egypt. There is not a coincidence that I'm filming it in the river. Yesterday I went and I did a mikveh, ice cold in the river. Remember the word of Acts, what are you waiting for? Go and wash out whatever your spiritual condition, turn back to Hashem, make a teshuvah. And I'm praying for you that as you read the book, you will receive the right tools to make teshuvah, to come back, to return. I want to pray for you today even, that the Lord God will strengthen you in the process of the teshuvah. And as you make the teshuvah, as you truly make teshuvah, I pray in the name of Yeshua that others around you will come closer to God. That is what God wants in the last days, for you to be the magnet, a human magnet, to bring many others closer to him, to you. And that's why I think the Besorah according to COVID-19 is so important, because he called you to become this great human magnet in these last days. So God bless you. Pick up the book and don't just look to the heavens like it says in the book of Acts and say, Yeshua come, Yeshua come. Prepare the ground. Starting in your own life, the loved one, prepare the ground for his coming. We would love to hear from you. We would love to get some feedback from you, how God transformed your life from the Besorah according to COVID-19, and just prepare and stay tuned for his coming in these last days. God bless you.